हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर राधिका केरकर. आई एम अ साइकेट्रिस्ट फ्रॉम अकोला. वेलकम टू दिस चैनल. सो आवर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज समथिंग रिलेटेड टू साइकोलॉजी. इट इज अबाउट अ पर्सन, इट इज अबाउट एन इंडिविजुअल, अबाउट अ साइको एनालिस्ट, एरिक एरिक्सन. सो फॉर दोज हु आर नॉट फ्रॉम दिस फील्ड और हु डू नॉट नो अबाउट हिम, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल अ बिट अबाउट हिम. So he was basically one of the most influential, considered as one of the most influential psychoanalysts of all times. Basically from Europe, he was in his youth, he was in Europe, and while working as a teacher, he got introduced to the field of psychoanalysis and then continued. He became a member of the society and then continued his work in this field. Later on migrated to the USA and there he continued his work a lot. He worked a lot with children and he developed this very famous theory of psychosocial development of humans, of all us individuals. So he was a faculty at Harvard Medical School. So he is one of the most well-known psychoanalysts for those who don't know. So today we are going to discuss about his theory, basically whatever he gave, psychosocial developmental theory he gave, and it has various stages starting from birth to the end of your life. So how a person develops, how he develops psychosocially, that is what he told in his theory. So we are going to talk about stage one of his theory. Basically, what he suggested is that a person, that an individual, faces a crisis sort of a situation at each stage in his life, at a particular stage in his life, whichever stages he mentioned. So he says that there comes a crisis. Basically, it is the difference between an individual and the society at that particular time, and whatever factors are playing in life that creates a sort of a crisis in his life. And if that individual is successfully completing that stage, he's successful in resolution of whatever dilemmas are faced during that crisis or whatever he faces at that time, if he successfully completes that stage, then it leads to development of a virtue in character. We all have virtues like being confident or being hopeful. These are the virtues in character that we normally have and we long to have. So he says that it develops gradually during a process in life, and at particular stage a particular virtue can develop if that stage is successfully completed. And similarly, if that stage is not successfully completed, if the person is unsuccessful in completing that particular stage due to XYZ reasons, then that can lead to a formation of a personality defect, or it is some kind of a characteristic trait which is not really desired. So that is what he basically is the crux of the theory. So specifically, if we go on to see the first stage, in this video we are going to discuss about the first stage, which is trust versus mistrust. So he said that trust versus mistrust, the formation of trust or mistrust, according to Erik Erikson, happens from birth to 1.5 years of age. That is what he said. So it is the first stage in his psychosocial developmental theory, and it begins from birth, as I said, and continues up to 18 months of age. So during this stage, now the newborn is just born, he barely knows anything about this world, everything is so new to him, and he's uncertain about what is there in this world in which he's living, and so he basically looks towards his primary caregivers on whom he's completely dependent on for some kind of stability and consistency of care. So I'll repeat. So what he said is, basically in this stage what is important is stability and consistency from the caregivers. So Erikson says that if the child gets consistent and predictable care during this period, there will be formation of a sense of trust which he will carry throughout his life in other relationships as well in the future, and he'll be able to feel secure even when there is a crisis later on in life or there is some threatening situation. He'll have that sense of security. He'll have trust in people. He'll trust people that they will be there for him. They will help him out. So that is the character trait that you develop if there is security and stability received at this stage. So I think it is so important to note that the ability to trust develops from such a young age, and I think it is so amazing to consider this. Likewise, if these needs are not met, if they are not met consistently, and that too for a very long time, it can create formation of mistrust or suspicion and fear and anxiety and all those things. That is what he says, that if care has been inconsistent, unpredictable, unreliable, then the infant will start developing a sense of mistrust, and he'll be suspicious towards people maybe in later on in life, and will not have the confidence that world will help him out or people are there to help him out. This feeling will not be so much there for him. One situation that I can think of is something like this can happen is that if parents are having some serious mental issues, for example, a hypothetical situation in which a baby is born but the parents are really unavailable for him and they themselves have some problems, they themselves are facing issues because of which they are not capable of taking care of this young one, and also if there is nobody else to take up that role, this lack of care is there for a very long time, then whatever Erikson is saying, this is very, I think, logical, and this can happen that we can imagine that a child is crying or is uncomfortable for a very long time and there is nobody to address that issue, there is nobody to take care of him in a consistent manner, then this thing can definitely happen. Then also what we spoke about, the formation of a virtue. So success in this stage will lead to the virtue of hope. That is developing a sense of trust, and then you can hope for good things to happen in your life. Infant can have hope that if such a crisis arises, there is a possibility that other people will be there for him and they will support him and he will have a support system. But failing to acquire this virtue will lead to the development of fear. What we see later on in so many psychological issues, so many psychiatric illnesses, there is a lot of fear. So it might have its roots in at such a young age. So this infant will carry a basic sense of mistrust, and he'll carry it on with other relationships as well and have a lot of anxiety, insecurities, and maybe have a lot of mistrust for the world around him. So always remember, the child this young always requires a lot of consistency in care and somebody who will attend to him when he's crying. Also remember that such a young child is not capable of manipulating anyone. So do not be under the impression that if a child is crying too much, he's just trying to get your attention for some reason or some thing like that, because a child this young is unable to manipulate anyone, and the only reason that he is crying maybe is because there is some uncomfortable position that he is in. So it must always be addressed. The child should always be comforted, or at least an attempt should be made in that direction, no matter what. So this was about the first stage. I hope you just got whatever I was trying to tell you about this stage, and in the further videos I'll post the next stages as well, and also more videos about children. So see you in the next video. Goodbye, until then.